Rich, my final question for you is, do you have any specific three tips for job seekers in terms of elevating their job search strategy?
My biggest, like, look, I'm an entrepreneur. I know what it's like to look for a job. I know how it feels. Here's what it does. Here's what I have to say when it comes to job searching. You might think you want the big brand. You might think you want the most money. You may think you want this type of remote work or whatever it may be, but start small. Start small. Don't pass up on a startup because they're a startup. You know, follow the people, okay? And this is where being present on social media matters. You may find someone who puts out great content and you might engage with them and maybe they'll remember you when it comes time for a job, or maybe you'll see you be able to say in the most nonchalant way, if you're ever looking to add on help in this area, this is what I do, please let me know. Mm-hmm. Like, that is different. You're already kind of top of the line at that point. You are competing with a lot of people with the big brands, but if you, you know, minimize the importance of working for a smaller company in which you could grow, then you might be missing out. A lot of job seeking and job searching is people want what they can't see is the journey. That's why I do what I do. I like to show the executives and the companies that are doing things. I like to show behind the scenes. You know why? Because the people in the company are more interesting than the company.
Yeah.
Okay. So look, like, if you and I didn't get along, you know how horrible that would be to work 10, 12 hours a day together?
Yeah.
Like, look for the type of people, the leaders, you know, in social media that, you know, you resonate with, and that might make your search a lot easier. As far as your expectations, I mean, there's a lot of different things, but I could tell you this. Money doesn't guarantee happiness, okay? Money guarantees that you'll probably spend it. So, you know, if you can really adjust your mindset to downsize or spend a little bit less and take the lower paying job because you think you'll be happier, that is worth it. That is absolutely worth it. And the other thing I would say when it comes to expectations is expect a long process. You cannot put all your eggs in one basket for this one company that you love so much. The interviews went so good. Everything's good. And then you never know. You think you're going to hear back in 7 days. You're like, it was a holiday week last week. Maybe they'll talk to me this week. It's been 2 weeks. Next thing you know, it's been 3 months. You can never, ever stop the job search if you are in a position where you need work or you're miserable like I was, you know, and you need to get out. You can never treat the job search or the job finding process. You can't take it lightly. It is a full-time job to look for a job, and the effort is well worth it if you commit to finding what you want. So don't undersell that. Okay, like, it takes a while, and you cannot put all your eggs in one basket. You know, you cannot just rely on this one company to come back and overwhelmingly say yes. So that's what I would say. Have a social media presence. And if you do, you will find the people that you like and the type of people that you feel like you probably enjoy working for. You can establish those connections, and it's going to be a lot easier for you to continue to put in the effort once you find the type of tribe, so to speak, of people that you would like to surround yourself with, because that's all we really want in the end. And I'll wrap up here, but that's all you want, is to be surrounded by people who are like-minded, who can help you elevate your progress personally and professionally. And that's it. You know, otherwise it's just a job.
Yeah. And again, as Gary mentioned, I believe when he was interviewing the CEO of the co-founder of Netflix, he was saying that surround yourself with positive, like-minded people. Or if you want to work in this industry, maybe you can be the admin or the other person of this great person that will open you other doors.
100%. Absolutely. Yeah. It's just find a way to be where you want to be. Even if it's not in the capacity that you want or that your strengths offer, just be there. And I'm just going to say this. I have had, I don't want to say luck, but I've had very good fortune. And it's because I'm very strict about where I go, where I spend my time, and who I'm going to network with. And it has worked out tremendously because I put myself in a position to be around the people who can make me better and can help my business.
Yeah.
Period. It's that simple.
I totally agree with you, Rich. And with that, my interview with you comes to an end. Again, it was a pleasure having this conversation with you, and I'm sure that my audience will benefit from the tips that you gave. And again, for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips for job seekers, please leave it in the comment section. Like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and tune in next time for a great interview I'm preparing for you. And Rich, again, thank you, and hope we can meet one day.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And I really, really enjoy what you're doing. And I do hope to meet sometime.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.